Hello everyone, welcome to Love Rebel. Emil, how are you?
Good, thank you. You're
finally we're getting to do this video. Guys, this is a Volvo S60R. It's not standard. And I've been wanting to drive one of these for the longest time because this car is very special. And it's very beautiful to look at as well. If I look at the competition, then it doesn't look this good. This car is gorgeous. Emil, tell me, what did you do to the car?
Stock motor and downpipe exhaust, cooler, injectors, pump, water meth, different turbo.
But
the motor
lot.
Is stock.
That's a lot.
Cape Town stock.
You actually just got off the dyno this morning.
Yes.
With this car. What power did this car produce?
Today, 1.2 bar was 275.
275 at 1.2 bar.
But she's very temperamental. She's supposed to be 1.4 on the dyno. That's like on the road.
That's a Volvo.
Yeah.
That's gonna be temperamental. Guys, so. Okay. Let me just get some of the things, the issues with this car over with in the beginning of this video, because other than those issues, this is a fabulous car. This car's got adaptive damping. Was one of the first, I think, cars around. It's not the first cars around, but it had adaptive damping.
Yeah.
And it's quite expensive. You were telling me it's how much is your?
Yeah, between 7 and 8 grand. Last per shock.
That's damn expensive. And then you have the angle gear, which is a common problem. They leak or they break.
Yes.
And that's how much, if I may ask?
15 to 20. But the collar sleeve is supposed to be broke first.
Oh, okay.
Yes.
Okay, cool. So the other thing with this car is this car was brought out to compete with the BMW M3 and Audi RS4 of the time.
Yes.
And obviously being Volvo, it was a very safe car. Gearbox feels fantastic, and already the 5-cylinder is making some rather fantastic noises. This car is lowered on
the Eibach.
Eibach springs.
Yes.
But it gets retaining the adaptive damping shock. Right? We're in the sport mode at the moment. The Emil says it's a bit better in sport.
Yeah.
But yeah, we'll put our foot down. I'm just waiting for all the bumps and stuff to disappear, and then we will. Guys, the sound.
5 cylinder.
The sound is phenomenal. So the one thing I'm really picking up with this car, the steering wheel is very, very light. And it feels very loose in my hands as well. The car doesn't fit. It just feels very light. I'm sure you noticed it as well driving other cars. I think it probably to make the car easier to drive than its competitors. Oh guys, but this is, I am gonna rev match between gears because I don't wanna damage his angle gear or his gearbox, because parts of this car is very expensive. And we don't want to say liberable broken meals, very prized position. Okay, yeah, this is not a slow car. Emil, the clutch on this car, are you still running the stock clutch?
Stock clutch.
Is this a dual mass flywheel?
Yes.
So if I may ask, what does a clutch cost as well for this car?
I got the quote, it was plus minus for the flywheel and the clutch. It was about 20, 25 if I remember.
It's actually quite pricey.
Yeah.
But I think that's going right now for dual mass flywheels and clutches.
Yes.
Right? Guys, he also played me the sound system, which I think, please don't quote me on this, you can comment in the comments below if I'm wrong, but I think this is a Dyna Audio Dolby surround sound, and the sound quality is exceptional, like way beyond what other people were putting out at the time in their cars.
15 years old.
Yeah, and it's always been a Volvo thing, I think, to have a great sounding sound system.
Wow. Motor included.
Yeah. If you is one of the character, check him out on Instagram. His Instagram handle is Valvoline. Not Wolverine, Valvoline. That's absolutely hilarious. The one thing I do like now, which I'm already starting to pick up on, are these seats. They are incredibly comfortable. You know what? If I had to be a wealthy man, I'd have been the Tyler Woolley of South Africa. I'd buy all the cars because, like, I want an M3, I want this, I want the C63. Like, I'm driving all these cars and I can't tell which one I like more. Like, climbing into this car now is like, ooh, this is, I could drive one of this every day. If the angle gear breaks, just take it out and make it front wheel drive and then blow with it. Yo, this car's beautiful. Like, I was driving up towards it where he was parking, and this thing hit my breath away. This thing is beautiful. Yo, and the clutch is like butter, and the gears. This gearbox feels fantastic. Okay, we'll do a first gear pull now. Again, guys, we can't do any launches here, so we're gonna roll into the power, right? I'm scared, it's quite fast. Holy hellfire. Bro, this thing is fast.
Does it feel like a big car?
Yo! Have you raced anyone yet with this car? Like a Golf R or something?
Nah. I only raced my Shadow.
Guys, third gear. Just breathe. Yo, if I may ask, so being a Volvo, how did you manage to get this car tuned and things? Who tuned the car? Like, wasn't it difficult? Yeah, in Cape Town especially, my apologies.
Yes, yes. I knew somebody here that was the middleman. Overseas, you get Rika. Mm-hmm. They made name many years ago with the starting tuning the 850 Volvos. Mm-hmm. So I've got a lot of experience with the Volvos. Mm-hmm. So we used this guy and did the logs and stuff. Mm-hmm. They changed the files a few times. Mm-hmm. And yeah, that's the end result.
That's really impressive. I may ask, was that an expensive endeavor?
Not that much.
Not that much. Okay. Yeah. Cool. And at least you have someone who can work on the car. Yes. If there's any codes and stuff that must pop up.
Yeah.
He was actually telling me this morning, the guy was telling me that there was some water on the floor. And it was his water bath pipe that came off.
It was not aircon water or radiator water, because, no, it looks clean, but it doesn't smell like antifreeze.
Emil also has another car. I'm going to put a picture up now. An 850R in almost like a Dakar yellow.
No, that was my favorite. T5. Mine is a red.
Is your one a red one?
Yes,
oh,
yeah.
If these are a red one, it looks gorgeous, guys. Like gorgeous. Guys, so Emil's up. Guys, Emil's Afrikaans, so he's very nervous on camera.
I use English only in self-defense.
You're actually very chilled, no?
Yeah.
I've got a couple of people on, especially after my accident, people are like, oh, I'm scared he's gonna crash my car. But, wow, Emil, thank you so much for this opportunity, and I'm sure they appreciate what's happening here. That we can showcase these kind of cars in Cape Town, because a lot of people think, who's watching my videos overseas, oh no, Cape Town's just full of Hondas, VWs, and Audis, and Nissans. No one's seeing that there's actually people in a very small numbers tuning these cars, and that's really, really, really special.
There's a lot of ST owners with Volvo engines.
They are, but it's an ST. It doesn't have the Volvo badge, you know, and it doesn't have the grace or the beauty of this car. This car is, this car's timeless. Like, every time I see an S60R, I'm like, yes, please, with these both the darker wheels. I think they're anthracite wheels. Guys, one other thing also this car, the torque, right? It might have a bigger turbo. What size turbo are you running?
GT30 spec.
GT30 spec turbo. And the torque is immense. I mean, I'm fifth gear at 60 kilometers per hour. I'm going to go to sixth gear now. There's enough torque. If I may ask Emil, what's your fuel consumption like?
I always behave myself and I went 120 max on this. But look, long as you get 10, if you go like that, but if you're overtaking cars fast, it can get a bit heavy on the social.
I remember back in the day when I was younger, before
that was with the dyno, everything.
Dude, 10.7, that's not bad. Oh my word, that's not bad. I was gonna say now, I remember back in the day there used to be a similar color like this that used to race at Kilani.
Yeah.
You know how fast that car was? That car was so fast. Guys, I'm getting just in a roll into the power. It makes when doing its business is phenomenal. Emil, thank you so much. It was an absolute honor. Thank you so much. Guys, please give this video a thumbs up, share it with friends and family, let them see what these kind of cars are like. Wow. I love this car. I like these weird type of cars. Oof. I'm glad I'm not a rich guy because I'd have been broke by buying all those different type of cars already. Anyway guys, I don't know what video is coming after this because I'm not too sure what my timeline looks at the moment, but I will speak to Emil. We can get his 850R on as well in the future. Maybe he's in a, probably, most probably keep that car video original because it is a collectible car. Yeah, in Cape Town. Be free, be you. Liberable out. Awesome.